Hey, what's up, guys? Toogie here, back again with another episode of my Finnish Nations United series right here on NHL 19. Uncharted territory for the Espoo Eagles. We are in round two of the playoffs, taking on the Ottawa Senators. We were able to get past Tampa, and while it was not a sweep, let's hope we avoid going the way of the Columbus Blue Jackets and blowing it in the second round. I had to say it. I'm sorry. That said, despite the fact that we won, I could not help myself. I did make slight changes to the lineup. We have brought in Juha Lomikko and Tuomo Virtanen on the fourth line, rather than having Patrick Virta and Sebastian Repo on the fourth line. Those two are a little bit more offensively oriented, and the hope here is that if we have Lomikko in the lineup and if we have Virtanen in the lineup, that generates just a little bit more offense from the top six or even the third line. And I still really like this third line, especially with how young Louis and Ludman are. Of course, Bjorkqvist will be leaving. Aside from that, shuffled up the second line a little bit. It's going to be Teräväinen and Lambert at center and Patrick Laine. Defensively, there was the question of what to do, who to move around. And I've gone with Hikola and Nudivaara as the top pairing. The main reason for that is Nudivaara only averaged 14 minutes through the first round, whereas Virtanen, who was on the top line, averaged a team-high 25 minutes and 53 seconds. So the thought process there is to have Nudivaara and Hikola be the big-time minute eaters for the team. Of course, Teräväinen and Kurvinen still there as well. The team at this point, a lot of discussion, a lot of debates, some second guessing, of course, over how we've gotten here. But again, at the very least, we have reached uncharted territory. We are in the second round. The Ottawa Senators, though, not exactly pushovers. 43 wins on the year, 8-2 heading into this postseason. And of course, they picked up a victory in round one as well. Let's take a look at what we are up against, shall we? Oh boy, that is horrifying. Wow, that winger depth is absurd. Their defense has to be terrible. Their defense or goaltending has to be terrible. It has to be their Achilles heel. There is just way too much money there. Unless guys like Robidon, Madden, and Tham are all still on their ELCs. Holy hell, though. Brady Tkachuk, 89 overall now at 26 years old. As you get a look at the attributes there, of course, you can pause, take a look if you want to, but two assists in the first round, centered by 35-year-old Matt Duchene, who again went back to Ottawa. Of course, this series started well after he was traded to Columbus, so it's interesting that he ended up back in Ottawa. He had 3 points in the first round. Still pretty strong attributes for someone his age. And then Travis Madden, who is 26 years old, 5 points in 6 games in the first round, number one overall pick in that extra draft that happens when you start up an expansion franchise, an unreal playmaker. Whew, $10.2 million per season. Their defense has to be miserable. Oh, not worth it. Wow, I really hope in the future here that we see this improved, because a player of this caliber should be able to do more, especially being next to Brady Tkachuk at the very least. Coming off of a 59-point season, his highest point total in 5 years, but still, that is pretty rough. You would expect more out of him, and maybe, unfortunately, we'll see that happen. They have Francois Robida, 21 years old, fourth overall pick in 2023. He is on the last year of his ELC. Good luck dealing with that contract. But he had 1 point in the first round. A pretty damn good two-way player. Centered by Trevor Wong, who was, of course, a real player. No points, though, in the first round. He was the 10th overall pick in 2021. Pretty damn good puck skills category. Also in the last year of his ELC. Oh, man. Try to remind me to look at Ottawa to see what they end up looking like next year, because it's going to be really interesting. Dorian Tam is 26 years old. Third overall pick in that draft, so he was picked up by the Red Wings, but he ends up in Ottawa alongside Madden. No points in the first round. And obviously, I'm concerned. because this means, as he has 1 year left, this is his final year of a nearly $6.8 million per season contract. You look at the lack of production amongst the top six, and that either means that the bottom six for them is outrageous, or they have had god-tier goaltending. It's one or the other. Yuraj Slavkovsky, he's a real player. Three goals in six games in the first round, 84 overall at 22 years old, was the seventh overall pick in 2022, last year of his ELC. Boy, this team. Chris Tierney, 5 points in six games. All right, that's pretty good for the 84 overall centerman. And Lincoln Weinrich, 2 points in six games. I guess it would be Weinrich. I'm thinking of Eric Weinrich. But I pronounce Weinrich too. I think it's Weinrich, though. Regardless, sixth round pick in 2020. Damn good steal for the Sens. 3 years left for the Denmark native. And we get to the fourth line. Braden Schenn at 34 years old. 3 points. It's not too bad. Oh, my God. Imagine having that on the fourth line. Oh, the AI needs to be smarter. If they have a terrible defense, but they kept Braden Schenn on the fourth line, it's a further example of the AI GMs needing to be much more intelligent. Even, like, again, whether or not you have a difficulty level within franchise mode or whatever, regardless, the AI should be smarter than that. Logan Brown, one goal on the fourth line, making $2.9 million. And Colin White also on the fourth line, only 2 points. Oh, my God. Imagine having, what, nearly $13 million bucks? Actually, yeah, it'd be about $13 million bucks for the fourth line. For the love of God, can we get smarter AI? Let's see how bad the defense is. Who knows? Maybe it's cheap, but my God, like, they're going to have, like, what are the odds that Weinrich ends up being, or Robida here, ends up being an RFA on the free agent list? Probably pretty high. Defensively, it's not as bad as I would have thought. And Erik Karlsson also ended up back in Ottawa. He's on the top pairing with Thomas Chabot, who only had 1 point in the first round. He's making $8 million bucks for the next 7 years. He's worth it, though. Erik Karlsson had 4 assists through the first round. He's on the final year of his deal. Second pairing, Max Lajoie, no points through 6 games. He's making $4 million bucks. Nicoletti, 1 goal in the first round. He was making 5. Okay, so they do have some money coming off the books. This is such a weird team, though. Ken Von Fersen. I don't think I've ever seen that surname in this game. Former first-round pick in 2022. Then we get to Scott Mayfield, 33 years old. No points through 6 games. The goaltender is 86 overall, Valeri Filatov, who is indeed god-tier, at least through 6 games here in the postseason. The Estonian, they're going to have to pay him a lot of money. Kruger, Connolly, and Frank the Tank for Toronto as healthy scratches. That is a much better team than I would have expected, especially in terms of defense and goaltending. You know, once we saw the forward core and how much money was there, granted they have a couple of guys on ELCs, but that is one of the more interesting teams I think I've ever seen. They have just under $2 million in cap space, really just under 1.8. That is a weird team, man. They're also trying to negotiate with them and Duchesne already. Crazy. That's one of my favorite things to do in this game, though, is to see how other teams build up their squad. Regardless, the intro to this video has gone on for quite a long time. Let's get down to the meat and potatoes of it all. Our second round matchup against the Sens. Can we continue the hot start to this postseason that began in the last one, where, of course, we won 4 straight games against Tampa? First period of game 1, and the Sens take the lead. Trevor Wong with the goal. We were tied in shots. Second period, it's a goal apiece. Matt Duchesne made it 2-0. Kasper Bjorkvist is able to get us back in it. Still down by a goal here as we enter the third period of play. The shots are still relatively close. We're getting a little bit of separation, and unfortunately, that's all for naught. Tyler Madden makes it 3-1. Juha Lamico gets a goal back, which is nice, or Lamico. Whether or not we can find a goal here in the last 5 minutes, though, who the hell knows? Complete toss-up. 2.5 left. Power play for the Sens. Shorthanded goal for Ludman, and we get to overtime. Oh, my God. Ludman is clutch. I think that's the only way to explain it. Lamico scores, Alamico scores, in his first appearance for us in the postseason here. And then with 40 seconds left, a shorthanded goal from the point, essentially, from Ludman. Crazy. 32 shots at 25. Three all on the board. We're going to overtime. In terms of a prediction, I have no idea. I just hope we win. Let's see what happens here. Who is going to take game one? The answer are your Espo Eagles. Or Espo Eagles. Louis gets the overtime winner. So a nice little come from behind victory. Lamico Ludman ties it with 40 seconds left. And Louis gets the winner. 4-3 final. The Eagles stun the Sens on the road. Two-point effort from Ludman. He was the first star of the game. Perhaps rightfully so. The third star was questionable. I can't believe Louis wasn't on the board for the game winner. But that is fine by me. The victory is all that we care about. And we do get the victory in game one. Again, a nice little come-from-behind victory. Philly has a 1-0 lead on the Islanders. Vancouver up 1-0 on Chicago. Anaheim up 1-0 on Dallas. Let's jump into game two. No lineup changes necessary. Let's see how this goes, shall we? First period. Not great for us. Matt Duchene, two goals in 20 seconds. Those are the only two goals of the period. Second period, they get another one with Brady Tkachuk. Simon Tyvall gets us back into the game. It is a two-goal deficit. 3-1 Sens heading into the third period. I'm getting to be a little bit concerned about our defensive efforts. We'll see if the offense can show up here against Filatov. We were able to get to him in game one. Power play chance for the Sens goes to waste. We need a goal here in the next few minutes or it is game over. And that is looking like it's going to be the case. Ottawa, off the back for sure of an empty net goal for Scott Mayfield. Take game two, 4-1 final. A very disappointing effort, I would say. Fortunately, we just never really got out of the gates offensively. Now, the good thing is, of course, we did at least take one game on the road. But that is pretty rough, I have to admit. I'm not sure whether or not I'll be looking at line changes here. Probably not. Although that top pairing, I'm now a little bit concerned. But at the end of the day, regardless of pairings, we should be able to find success. We really should be able to. Between Lamico, Vertanen, and Lekkonen, it's not that bad. Need the top six to show up. Talked about it. You know, changing up the fourth line to try and generate more offensive chances for that top line. Kapokako's been very quiet thus far. Rantanen, very quiet thus far. We need them to show up as we go home. Hosting Ottawa here. It's game three. I would say we're in desperate need of a win. First period is scoreless. Decent little change of pace. They nearly doubled us up in shots. Second period, that is much better. Ludman and Simon Tyvall. Third and first lines showing up. We're being outshot 23-16, but we have the 2-0 lead as we begin the third period. I'm a little bit worried about our defensive structure. We'll see if we can close this game out. Hopefully we can. That is exactly what I was afraid of. Tyler Madden scores. 8 minutes left. This one is far from over. Can we get the insurance goal or simply shut them down? Lukanen, 2 minutes left. Can you close them out? Thank God he can. 2-1 final. They outplayed us, I'd say, ever so slightly, at least in terms of the shots. But a big-time second period. Ludman and Simon Tyvall, whose goal holds up as the game winner, lead the way. And a 32-save effort from Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen gets the job done. 2-1 series lead for the Eagles. And I'm feeling much, much better. Tommy Ludman tied for the team lead in points right now with Kapokako. That is a beautiful thing to see with how much we gave up to trade up to get him. Obviously, right now, in terms of staying loyal to certain players and an effort to stop me from flipping them, I know some people want me to go back on that. And I think the excuse to go back on that would be making sure that Tommy Ludman can play the top line minutes that he deserves to play because he is an absolute monster. I will point out Philadelphia. They have a 3-0 series lead on the Islanders. Odds are the winner of this series will go on to play Philly. And we could take a commanding 3-1 series lead as well if we can walk away with a victory here. in game four. So let's do this. First period, and we have a 2-1 lead. Mika Rantanen shows up, thank God. Robidas is able to tie it under a minute later. But then Arturi Lekkonen on the fourth line shows up, gets it done. By the way, Rantanen scored, I guess, on a wraparound. That's the only thing that really makes sense. And Robidas front kicked Lukanen through the goal. He's standing right in the crease. Brett Hull approved. 2-1 lead. 16 shots to 9 at the end of the opening 20 minutes. Second period. And we add to it. Mika Rantanen again. 3-1 for the Eagles. And we are 20 minutes away from having a 3-1 series lead. We had a bit of a scare trying to close out the last game. Let's see if that's the case this time out. Can Ottawa battle back? Or do we have this under control? Power play for the Sens is killed off. We get a power play of our own. That goes to waste as well, but we're over halfway done with this third period. Do we have enough? Can Lukanen stand on his head and get the job done? 2 minutes left. 3-1 final in game four. A 3-1 series lead for your Eagles over the Ottawa Senators as Mikko Rantanen shows up. 25 save effort from Lukanen and Arturi Lekkonen on the fourth line chipping in as well. Not too shabby whatsoever. Our first of three opportunities to close out this series presents itself now in game five. We are 1-1 away from taking on Philly in the conference final. Both Chicago and Anaheim have a 3-1 series lead out west. Let's do this. No lineup change is necessary. Let's see what happens. I'd like to think we have this under control, but I've been proven wrong before. First period, we get the lone goal, the opening goal. It's Ludman again. He is going to be something special for this series and for this team, isn't he? Our 1-0 lead. Oh, let's hope we can hold on to it. Second period. We didn't hold on to it. Thomas Chabot was able to tie the game, but we took over from there. Kasper Bjorkqvist and Mikko Rantanen again, who has woken up, and damn it, when you wake up an offensive threat this dangerous, it's tough to shut him down. 2 goals in under a minute. 3-1. Heading into the third period, we are 20 minutes away from punching our ticket to the conference final, where we'll be taking on the Philadelphia Flyers. Can we shut the door? Power play chance, an extended power play chance, and there we go. Mikko Rantanen scores again. 4-1. I am going to have to remember to take a look at how that went down. Ottawa with an extended power play as well. I'm guessing we're trading majors. Under 2 minutes to go, and that is it. We beat Tampa in 5. We've beaten Ottawa in 5. 4-1 final there in game 5. Rantanen with the 2 goals. Ludman with the 2 points. 23 saves for Lukanen. And I totally forgot to check the penalties. Damn it. How I wish it was like most other games where you could check the stats afterwards if you accidentally back out. It's not. Trust me, it's something that's been mentioned. But at the very least, we're moving on. It'll be Chicago and Anaheim in the West, Philadelphia and Espo in the East. Let's take a look at the stats here. Let's get a look at the team. Beautiful performance overall. Lukanen in a 936 save percentage has rebounded well after that slow start against Tampa. Beautiful from the top goaltender in the league right now. Thomas Hikola, 3 points through 10 games, a plus 2, averaging 23 minutes per game. Nudivaara with 2 points, a plus 6, up to 18 minutes per game, which is what I wanted to see. On the second pairing, Tiervainen, 4 points and a plus 5, averaging 18 minutes. Kervainen, 2 points and a plus 5. That third pairing, Virtanen, still averaging quite a bit of time. 2 points and a minus 3. Kuka averaging 15 minutes per game. He's got that plus 6. Virtanen does have power play time, though, because of the puck skills category for obvious reasons. So that would explain the extra ice time. On the offensive side of things, Kapokako had a quiet, at least a relatively quiet round that time out. If I'm not mistaken, did he have 8 points in 6 games and only have 1 point there? I know he didn't score a goal in that round. Simon Tavall up to 8 points, and then Rantanen's at a point a game. Again, he woke up and took over in the final few games of that series. Teuvo Teravainen, 5 points through 10. Same for Brad Lambert, who's having some discipline issues despite an 85 rating in that category. Patrick Laine, 5 points, one goal through 10 games. Extremely concerning. And again, I know that I was experimenting around and still am, of course, with trying to stay loyal to certain players. I know a lot of people have been like, yeah, gloves off. If we do go gloves off and I can do whatever, I mean, whether or not we'd keep Patrick Laine, I don't know. I mean, he did put up 37 goals for us this year, but playoff-wise, I mean, his production's a bit hit or miss outside of that one effort there. I mean, really, it's just been the past 2 years in the postseason. So since he joined our team is when he's quieted down. Not a good sign. We go to the third line. Bjorkqvist playing for a big-time contract, but he has 6 points through 10 games. 6 points for Samu Lui, and the 10 points, 6 goals in 10 games for Tommy Lidman, again, just 19 years old. He is going to be the face of this series, if I had to guess. Changed him to a two-way, still scoring goals for fun. Now, the fourth line, Lemieux, very good. Very good. More than what I possibly could have asked for. Tuomo Virtanen also did very well, and Lehkonen up to 4 points. So, very happy with what we're seeing from this team. Certain players are underperforming, but again, you always have that argument of, oh, well, we're winning, and if that person wakes up, how the hell are we going to be stopped? That's always the debate. That said, we are done here for today. Next episode, we take on the Philadelphia Flyers in the Eastern Conference Final. Again, this is the furthest we have been in this series. The team, again, a lot of things have changed with it, but it's worked out thus far, and we'll see whether or not we can continue to take that next step forward. Philly only lost one game out of 9 thus far. I have a feeling it's going to be an interesting challenge. I'll see you guys next time. You know the deal. Check out everything in the description if you haven't already. Leave a like on the video, or again, as promised, really Philip DeFranco influence lately, but physical harm if you don't leave a like. Physical harm. Get my nephews to kick you in the shin. I'll get my dog to, I'll force you to hold my dog's leash and she'll jump up and impale you with her nails. Painful stuff. I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one, and I'll see you then.